it is show day today. What you're seeing here is pretty much what has been going down this whole day. It's a lot of feet up and resting, keeping dry. Not too much today, nothing crazy. I'll show you guys some of the meals that I'm gonna prep before we head out. We're gonna go do our second coat of 10, probably get another meal in, and then it's off to the races and we're gonna go to the venue. I'm pretty much getting just three meals in. The show's about midday, which is nice because I can fit three meals in and we can kind of, you know, play with how we're looking. But everything was looking pretty good after yesterday's cheat meal. We woke up in the morning, did fasted check-ins in person. Everything stayed dry. Everything looked pretty good. So we just want to maintain the fullness. So this is just literally just some maintenance meals to go into the show. I'm planning on getting these three in a little bit earlier before the show, and then backstage I'll just have small snacks to keep me full and keep the muscle full, not my body, you know, my stomach full, of course. The whole point is just to keep the stomach empty. So I rather have these meals now a little bit earlier, and then that would allow me to digest. And then after, I can use whatever snacks backstage in order to just maintain that and keep the stomach down so there's no distension or any digestion that'll you know, can be seen on stage, right? So there's all small things that you gotta really consider when you're going up on stage that don't really seem like much but could make a big difference, right? This has been the whole day right now, just feet up, resting. I'll show you guys these meals that I'm gonna prep. Come follow me for the journey, we're almost there. 200 grams of jasmine rice. 90 grams of steak, which is just like 3 ounces, not much. Meal three is gonna consist of the same thing. I'm gonna get a Tupperware and actually do that right now. This is meal three. I'm gonna eat meal two. I'm gonna take some vitamin C and digestive enzymes with both these meals. And then another thing that I'll be doing is basically having just 250 mLs of water, as well as the rice cakes backstage. So this is the little backstage snacks that will hold me off after eating these two meals, guys. I'm gonna get this meal down, head out, get my other rest of coats of tens, have my meal three, and then it's off to the showtime. All right, guys, so got the second coat of tan done. Went faster than expected, so even though I packed meal three with me, I was planning on eating here. I'm just gonna have it back at the Airbnb. From there, we'll pack whatever else I need, and then we're off to the venue and get the show on the roll. So the next couple clips you'll probably see me will be at the venue and up on stage. So super exciting, guys. Let's see how this goes. So, looking forward to it. Back lat spread, big one on the nose.
Order turn to your right. Tony goes with the man. Side tricep. Hold on to the step. Continue with this one.
Jonathan Fiasanti à venir faire sa routine.
Notre gagnant men's bodybuilding open heavyweight, le numéro 59, Andrew Thériault.
Hands up, everybody. I know, don't fly. One more time. There we go. We're all friends up there. All right, so money, that's it. Only the athletes. Okay, guys. Front double bicep. Give us a nice shot for the photo. We got the shot. Thank you, guys. Just a winner now. Just a winner. All
right, guys. We're back at the Airbnb. As you can see, we got second place. Still qualify for nationals, which is great. Being so hard on myself all the time, of course I wanted to get first and have that moment, but hey, first show, second place in a heavyweight class where, you know, I made the weight by like 2 pounds, so I was on the bottom of the class. Still pretty proud, you know. Even the package that we put up on stage and just in general with my whole bodybuilding career or, you know, lifestyle, all these years, this is probably the best ever looked. So we brought a really good look, you know, I'm super happy with it. Joe's an amazing coach and, you know, I trust him with everything, and we pulled up our best. So now going into the nationals, we're gonna try to make the light heavyweight category and come in with a sharper package. I'll be at the top of the class too, so that gives us some good motivation to know that I'm coming in with, you know, a sharper, different look that's in another category, and give that a shot. Not taking away anything from this. This is still great, but yeah, just setting some new goals for the next show, and hopefully we get a top five. If not, I'm just still super happy and grateful for everything. So, second place, guys. We're gonna have some good food tonight. You guys are gonna see that shortly. You might get pretty surprised at the amount of food we can eat, especially when you got like three bodybuilders that are gonna be hammering it out. So, three bodybuilders and a sushi joint and a pizza place and some dessert. So you guys will see that shortly. And
we are off, and this car is small as fuck. When you order an Uber XL and it's like a Golf. Damn.
I'll sit in the front. man.
Thank you.
Many little things.
Really good.
A slow crab, avocado.
And just salmon, some mango sauce with crab or something in the middle. I don't know. It's very light.
Yeah. We ain't finished yet.
After like $1,000 of sushi, we are going to be working on this now. So this is the epic post-show cheat. We have some Napoleon pizzas, wood oven. We have Detroit style pizza. We got Krispy Kremes. We got some cheesecake. We got some my cookie place, half pound cookies over here. We weigh a ton. Some curly fries, guys, and a whole bunch of Häagen-Dazs pints that we're just gonna mix up and eat. So that's everything. Let's see how much we could finish. So let's get this down, guys, and enjoy it. I'm super excited. Guys, here we are, post show. As you guys saw yesterday, we went pretty hard on the cheat meal. I didn't really make it after all that food. I felt my sugar spike up like crazy, and I just saw the bed, hit the hay. I wanted to just digest for like another 10 minutes and get like some ice cream or something, but I just passed out and was gone. So here we are now. I'm up, I'm alive, I'm feeling okay. You know, everything's still digesting okay, surprisingly. We're keeping it clean this morning, so, you know, just some oats and some whey, just very easy digesting stuff. You know, very simple, plain. So, we got the second place placing in heavies, which I'm really proud of. I'm still proud of it, because only for the simple fact that, you know, going into the show, I planned on being a light heavy from day one. That was kind of our goal. But throughout the prep, my body wasn't really reacting the way that we thought it would, where we'd be dropping to that weight to make that weight cut. So we did the heavies anyways, right? So day of the weigh-in, we weighed 201, and light heavy cutoff was 198.5. So literally by about 1.5 pounds, let's just say, or 2 pounds, let's say 2 pounds, I missed that weight, right? But I figured, hey, there's no excuses. Let's bang with the heavyweights. Come in super dry, super hard, which we were very dry. Best conditioning that I've ever been in general, in my whole entire life, to be honest. So I figured, you know what? It can be a good shot. Let's go in it anyways and see what happens. We did the show. Everything went according to plan, sort of. Things never go the way you plan them out in your head. So I'm not going to get into it too much. In terms of how shows are arranged, but there were little hiccups and rushing and times where cortisol levels got shot up and I became a stress ball, but you know, pulled it together, focused, got on stage, no excuses. Now with these shows, it really comes down to who shows up, right? So you know, you could be the best guy there in terms of experience and everything and relative competition, but hey, someone can show up. They've been doing it for 10 years, 15 years, and, you know, there would not really be much, you know, competition or because of the fact that it's someone who's so seasoned in it, right? So I went up there, did the heavies, you know, props to the guy who won and took first place. He won the overall as well. He bet everyone. He's been in the game for 15 years, very long time. You know, I've done a lot of national shows as well. So the fact that for my first debut show, I could line up beside a guy like that and still hold my ground and look pretty good and not feel out of place makes me really happy, right? And now we qualified for the Toronto Pro in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. And that's going to be in 4 weeks. So this is the national show, bigger show. So our game plan for the national show now, which is exciting because I'm a little bit, I guess, salty that the fact that it's a second and not a first. Of course, you want to come in and dig a first and go into a bigger show knowing you were first, right? But the game plan for this next show is basically we're going to try to make the light heavyweight cut. So we're going to try to lose those extra 2 pounds, which should be relatively easy. And in doing so, I won't be losing too much muscle, right? The 2 pounds isn't much. So I'll have that same density and fullness, but I'll be able to bang with the light heavies, right? So I'll be at the top of my weight class opposed to being at the bottom, bare minimum of the heavyweight weight class. And we'll also be bringing in a sharper look as well. So we're gonna get even tighter, even harder. And then we're gonna bring that to the show and see how we do. I'd be super happy with like a top 5, even like I'd even be happy with like an 8th out of 20 guys, like, you know what I mean, just somewhere falling in the middle or top 5 even, I'd be super happy for this first run, you know what I mean. And the best thing is that when you're up there on stage, you can really see what you need to work on and what you want to do to improve in the future, right? So a couple things I want to improve on in the future will be, I believe maybe I feel like my lats need to become wider and more V-tapered. They look really well in a lat spread, but when I hit a rear double bicep, even a front double bicep, that's where he got me, where it needs a little more flare in order to give that illusion of me having a smaller waist with that big V-taper. So our lats are going to be one of the things that we really want to bring up, I feel. And then overall, like, I'm happy with the leg development. We brought that up like crazy. You know, maybe bring up some shoulders. My arms are looking okay. That was always a decent point. So I think maybe some shoulders and lats, if we can really grow them and isolate those muscles to get the specific lagging parts going, we'd bring a really good package come 2 years from now or 1 year from now when I decide to go for our next run. So that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed these vlog style videos. It's very just, you know, raw, as if you were here with me. I appreciate all the support you guys have been giving me through everything. You know, it means the world that you guys can follow me through this first time. And I hope you guys enjoyed it, got some tips or info on, you know, what goes down and how things are done. And yeah, we're going to go shoot for the Toronto Pro in 4 weeks. So I'm back to some clean meals today. I got a little bit of freebies that from coach's orders. So maybe enjoy a couple other things, but nothing too crazy like you guys saw last night. And then it's back to the drawing board. We're back to on the grind. So 4 weeks, Toronto Pro, it's set. We're gonna bring a new package and hopefully it goes well. So thanks for everything, guys. Comment, like, subscribe. And this is gonna close out the debut competition series vlog. So take care, guys. All the best.